Hi, in this video, we will learn how to create charts with dynamic ranges. Here is a line chart showing share prices of company ABC Limited. As we change the date range, the chart data changes automatically. Let us discuss how to create such a chart from scratch. So first, I will start by deleting the existing chart. Delete the list and then average share price. Let's start. Here we have share price of ABC Bank Limited from 1st June 2015 to 25th May 2020. So the data extends till row 266. Let us start by creating the start and end date range. So we click on start date, go to data, data validation, and then select list. In the source, we select the start and end date. So click on cell B6, which is the first date, and then press shift control and down arrow key to select the range, and then press OK. So we have our start date. And we can just press Ctrl C to copy and paste it as the end date. So we have our data range list ready. Now, before creating a dynamic chart, let us start with a simple basic line chart. So we'll select the date range, go to insert and click on line chart. So this is the line chart we get. I'll do a bit of formatting changes. So I'll delete the grid lines and that's it. When we right click on the chart and click on select data, and within select data, we click on edit, we see the chart range. So it shows cell C6 to C21 to produce the output. So in case we want to select from 1st June to 14th September, it has to select a range C6 to C21. Now, which is a formula which can help us create a range? We can use an index formula over here. When we use the index formula like this, index formula, then semicolon, and then index formula again, it gives us a range. So let us start by creating the date range. To create a date range, we'll type index. Array is the date range. So press Ctrl Shift and down arrow key to select the range. So this is the array. Then what do we want to match? We want to match a row which is equal to the start date. So we will use the match function over here. So type match. Lookup value is the start date, comma, and where does Excel has to search for this data? It has to be the date range. So again, press Ctrl Shift and down arrow key, comma. We want the exact match. So 0 and then bracket close, enter. So we get a number which shows the start date. Now press F2. And for the end date, again, we'll use the index function. So we will use semicolon, index, again, select the same date range, Ctrl Shift down arrow, comma, match. Match is the end date this time. So it is cell G5, comma, it has to look in the date range, and then we need the exact match, bracket close, enter. So this formula gives us the date range. Before checking the output, let us first fix all the cells. So press F2 and then press F4 to fix all the cells, because fixing is really important here. Now click on F2, select the formula, and press F9. So you get four values over here, which is between the start date and end date. So the start date is 8th June 2015, end date is 29 June. So if we look at the data, we have a range with four data inputs. So the formula is working fine. If we extend the date further to 5th October and then press F2, select the formula and press F9. So we get a broader range. So this formula is working fine. Now we'll do a similar exercise for the price range. So start with index. The index is the share price range. So select cell C6 to cell 266, comma, match. What do we match here? We match the start date again. So match the lookup value is cell G4, comma, look in the date column, cell B6 to B266, comma, we need the exact match, bracket close. For the end price range, we will press a semicolon and then again type the same formula, index, price range, comma, match. Match the end value, which is cell G5, comma, in the date column, comma, we need the exact match, bracket close, enter. So here we again have the date. We can change the format by pressing Ctrl Shift and 1. So it changes to the date. So if we look at the share price, it is 545.38, which is same as the share price on 6th July. Because the formula is in row 11, it takes the share prices of row 11 as it did earlier with the date range. We will fix the formula first, so press F2 and then F4 to fix the ranges. To check whether the formula is working fine, again click F2. Select the formula and then press F9. You get the share prices between 8th June to 5th October 2015. So this is also working fine. Now, what do? We can copy and paste this formula in the chart so that when the date ranges changes, the price also changes. So we copy this formula, press Ctrl C. Then click on the chart, right click and then choose select data. Click on edit and then press Ctrl V to paste the formula and press OK. It says that function isn't valid. Excel charts doesn't recognize complicated formulas as we have over here, but it recognizes cell names or formula names. If we give this formula a name, it should work. So we will get out of this chart, copy this formula and go to formulas, name manager, click on new and then paste the formula, Ctrl V. To this formula, we'll give a name, price range, put an underscore between the words because name manager does not recognize spaces. Click on OK. So we have the price range formula. If we click on the formula, we see that it selects the range of the dates which we have entered as input. So it is working. Again, we will copy the date range formula, Ctrl C, go to formulas, name manager, click on new, paste this formula and then say date underscore range. OK, close. Now, we again go to the chart, click on the chart, right click and then say select data. Click on edit and here we can give a name as price range. So we type is equal to price range. Click on OK. This shows an error because to use a formula name in an Excel chart, we also have to give a sheet name. So we will type is equal to chart price underscore range and then click OK. So we have the price range working. We will do the same for the date range as well, because date has to be aligned with the price range. So click on the edit and type is equal to chart and then date range, which is the name given to the date formula. Click on OK and then OK. So now we have the chart ready. So if I change the date ranges, the chart gets updated automatically. So if I choose from start date, which is 1st June 2015 to 18th May 2020, the chart gets updated automatically. Similarly, if I reduce the range, it gets automatically updated. So as the date range. Now, the next step is to calculate the average share prices. So average share prices is simple. So we can just type the formula is equal to average and then price underscore range, which is the price range in our formula, and click OK. So we get the average share price for the date selected, which is 814 rupees in this case. If we reduce the range, let's say from 1st June to 6th July, it changes to 523. So if I select the dates and then see the average, it is 523.3. So the calculation is correct. Now we need to place this average share price on the chart. So click on insert, shapes, and then select an oval. Put an oval on the chart. Go to insert, text box, average share price. Reduce the font size to 8. Place it just beside the oval. Now, to link the oval with cell G7, click on the oval. In the formula bar, type is equal to G7 and then click enter. We get the average share price. Change the font color to white and then bold it so that it stands out. Here we go. So we have the average share price along with the share prices. So if I change the date range to 24th August, the chart changes along with the date range and the average share price. Hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you. Keep learning and have fun.